Hello and welcome to this QuickCapture tutorial. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to take advantage of user inputs in a QuickCapture project. QuickCapture's big buttons automatically capture a set of predefined attributes with each observation. User inputs allow you to manually enter additional information when capturing data. There are two types of user inputs in QuickCapture: project user inputs and button user inputs. Project user inputs allow mobile workers to enter global values prior to data collection that will be written to fields in every captured record. This could be, for example, a cost code or a team name. Button user inputs are used to collect additional information that is associated with the specific button. A button user input is shown when a button is pressed. For example, the severity of an issue that's being captured. Let's go through how to set up user inputs for a project. In the QuickCapture web designer, select New Project. Select Start from Template and choose the Urban Search and Rescue template. This template demonstrates how QuickCapture can be leveraged to support urban search and rescue efforts. Select Use Template and complete the required information. Once deployed, you can customize the project to fit your organization's needs. Each button represents an observation type to be captured by the field crew with a set of predefined attributes. The next step is to add fields to the target feature layer to store the additional information that will be captured by user inputs. Select Manage Project Layers. Select View Item Details from the Options menu. This will take you to a hosted feature layer view in your ArcGIS content. Navigate to the feature layer that the view was created from. Go to the Data tab and select Fields. Select Add. Add new fields for operator name, team name, event name, notes, and severity. Go to the severity field and select Create List. Add low, medium, and high to the list of values. Select Save. Go back to the web designer and refresh the browser. The new fields are now available as capture fields for each button. Project user inputs must be created at the button level. They can then be managed at the project level. Select a button to apply a project user input to. Go to its Data tab. Select Project User Input for the Operator Name field. I'll give the input a label, make it a single line text input, and make it required. I'll do the same for the team name, but this time I'll use a choice list. I'll also add a project user input for the search event name. Once one or more project user inputs have been created, they can be managed in the project settings. Here you can edit, rename, and delete project user inputs. You can also change the order that the inputs will be presented in the QuickCapture mobile app when the project opens. So far, I've only applied the project user inputs to one button. To apply these inputs to all buttons in the project, select the remaining buttons by holding the Shift key. Apply the project user inputs to each field in the Data tab. Save your project. Project user inputs will now be written to their respective fields each time a button is pressed. Let's see how the project user inputs work in the mobile app. I've downloaded my new project. When I open it, I'm prompted to enter the project user inputs. If a project user input is required, you must enter a value before you can start capturing data. If a project user input is not required, it can be left blank. During data capture, I can edit the values for the project user inputs at any time. The updated information will be applied to new observations after the changes have been made. Project user inputs you've previously entered will be displayed under the input the next time you open the project. This allows you to quickly re-enter the same information. I'll capture a few observations using the hazard and occupants buttons. And here are the observations in a web map. In the attribute table, we can see the project user inputs have been populated for each record. Button user inputs are configured in a similar way to project user inputs. Unlike project user inputs, you can only apply one button user input for each button. Select the Animal Hazard button. On its Data tab, select Button User Input for the Notes field. Create a new button user input. Apply the same button user input to the other hazard buttons. Select the first Occupants button. Create a new button user input for the Severity field. The low, medium, and high choices are populated automatically from the list of values for the Severity field. Now you can apply this Severity button user input to all other Occupants buttons. First, I'll update the project in the mobile app. Now I'll capture some hazard and occupant observations and enter their button user inputs. The button user input dialog is displayed when a button is pressed. Like with project user inputs, a button user input can be skipped if it's not required. In the web map, here we can see the project's observations with the user inputs collected for each observation. For more information on user inputs, see the ArcGIS QuickCapture blog on Esri Community. Thanks for watching.